joy and peace to all the people of the earth. Let's receive the word of God with Reverend Kiluba or Kiluba. May God bless you.
Dear online listeners and dear listeners from the local radio stations, all of you who follow us on a weekly basis, we would love to say firstly thank you for receiving us in your home with the Word of God. We greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus, who reigns. We greet you in the name of the one who reigns in all the earth. All power has been given unto me in heaven and on earth. Go, therefore, and make of all nations disciples. And that is why we greet you in the name of the one that is ruling on the earth and who asked us to teach the nations of the earth with his certain assistance. And behold, I am with you every day until the end of the age. We are assured of his presence, his faithful and permanent and powerful presence as we do this work online and for some local radio stations. Let me read us a few scriptures, four scriptures. Firstly, in Matthew chapter 24, verse 29 to 31. Immediately after the distress of those days, the sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from the sky and the heavenly bodies will be shaken. Why are they shaken? Why are these bodies shaken? It is because the sun of men is going to land in order to gather. Verse 30, then will appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then all the peoples of the earth will mourn when they see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great joy. Verse 31, and he will send his angels with a loud trumpet call, and they will gather his elect. Oh, hallelujah! From one end of the heavens, from the four winds, and from one end of the heavens and to the other. What a power of gathering from the four corners of the earth, a power to gather that has the Son of Man, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And I would love that today that we may stop on his ability to gather. The Bible says our ability comes from God. You're going to receive today in your respective cities the ability to gather that has the Son of Man, because you believe in him. Oh, hallelujah. And he says, he who believes in me will do the works that I do, and the Son of Man is a gatherer, believing and gathering. Oh, hallelujah. As the faith that Jesus proposed to his friendly family in Bethany, I would love that you should not be in families or friendly to families where Jesus is not. This family was a friendly family where Jesus was, and Jesus said to them, if you believe, you will see the glory of God. And when Jesus had resurrected Lazarus, the festival of the triumphant entry of Jerusalem had begun with the faith of women. And that is why I believe women can gather, just as Catherine Kuhlman and other women of God who have made history by gathering, and they also birthed other people who gather. I'd love to continue my reading in Matthew chapter 25, verse 31. That is why I'm speaking about you, to you about this man. When the Son of Man, I'm speaking to you about the Son of Man. We read him in Matthew 24. We read regarding the Son of Man. You are Son of Man, dear pastor. He knows how to transmit to you his ability to gather. Oh, hallelujah. This message I'm giving to you today is going to regenerate assemblies of Jesus all around the nations of the earth. We need assemblies that are worthy of the King. The Bible says a great multitude is the glory of the King. And you are going to receive this grace that is awesome. It is made available as I am speaking, and it is coming from the one who has always gathered. When the Son of Man will come in his glory with all the angels, he will sit on the throne of his glory, and all the nations will be gathered before him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He knows how to help you to have the ability to gather. I'll read the third scripture.
Text.
Luke 24, verse 49. I am going to send you what my Father has promised. I will send. He knows how to send. I will send on you. Wherever that you are, he knows how to send on you. Send on you. Oh, receive the anointing of gathering and not the anointing of scattering. Gather masses for Jesus, who is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and a multitude of people is his glory. He lives in glory. Glory.
Glory.
And glory. Glory.
Was hallelujah.
Glory, glory, hallelujah. We have read it. When he shall come in the glory of his Father, it is the glory of his Father to gather. The Bible says about the Father, he is enthroned on the praises of Israel. Oh, hallelujah. And he says, you will be the subject of my praises in the great assembly. Verse 49 of Luke 24, I will send to you what my Father promised. But you remain in the city until you are clothed from the power from on high.
But I would
love that you may stay in the city in a good manner. There are people who are in the city for useless things, but the disciples and apostles remained in the city in a good manner. How do you live in the cities where you are, in the nations? It says, but you remain in the city until you are clothed with the power from above. I want you to stay in the city in a good manner before the Lord. Some people are in the city just to eat and drink wine, drink hamburgers, and on all these things. They may be good for food and beverage, and we eat them with thanksgiving, but we want you to eat another food. Oh, yes. That will never perish, that the Son of Man will give you. Says, my food is to do the will of the one who has sent me. And he will use a woman in order to gather, oh hallelujah. The Samaritan woman was an instrument of a gathering. After experiencing many divorces, marital hurt. She had divorced for almost 5 times, and Jesus wanted to propose to her something better, give her something better. He made of this woman with a broken heart. I want to say to you, in your broken hearts is hidden the glory of God, because God is near to all those who are broken of heart. May the Lord plaster your broken hearts. There are people who have broken hearts because of sin and the evil that they do. So God knows how to break those hearts. It is like the two thieves at the cross of Jesus. They broke their bones because they were thieves. I say to the brothers and sisters and to the unbelievers, if you do not stop sinning, you are going to be broken and hurt by sin. As the two thieves at the cross, their bones were broken. Do you know the pain of the breaking of bones? It is ferocious. Why? Why did they end up with broken bones? It is because they found pleasure in breaking the lives of other people. Some people find pleasure in breaking the hearts of other people. You too will be broken. And the Samaritan woman had a broken heart because of her misgivings in her marital relationships. I want to finish my reading that has taken quite some time now. I wanted to do it this way so that we could go directly to the title of today. We're going to read in the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, verse 8. But you will receive power. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and you are going to be my witnesses. Hallelujah. In Jerusalem and in all of Judea, in Samaria, places of gathering. Samaria, the place of gathering of Philip and the Samaritan woman, and you'll be my witnesses until the ends of the earth. Behold, the reading for you who are following us online and those who are following us on some radio stations. The topic that we are going to give to you today is gathering. Gathering
par l'assemblée céleste.
By the heavenly assembly.
Rassembler.
Gathering.
C'est notre sujet.
That is our topic today.
J'aimerais attirer votre attention d'entrée de jeu.
And I would love to call to your attention as I begin.
Dans le ciel, il y a.
In the heavens, there is.
Des assemblées qui rassemblent.
Assemblies that assemble, assemblies that gather. Oh, hallelujah. And when Jesus enters the world through Bethlehem, he entered the world with the heavenly assembly. Hallelujah and hallelujah. Today you are going to receive the grace to gather by the heavenly assembly as Jesus had it in Bethlehem.
It
says, I bring you good news. Unto you is born in the city of David. And the Bible adds, there was a multitude that joined the angel. What a heavenly army that was singing, glory to God in the highest and peace on earth. That is why in all the revivals there was a power of praise and worship. I'm speaking to brothers and sisters who are taking care of worship and praise in churches and in the crusades. You are being enrolled in the assembly of the gathering. And that is why watch over your conduct. Sometimes there are many things that happen in choirs among musicians. Sometimes these things can be dirty and not good. You are not alone. The Bible says, then a multitude of angels joined the angel. It was a warrior assembly. Oh, hallelujah. Jesus said, you will have tribulations in the world, but be ye of good courage. I have overcome the world. He had with him
l'assemblée céleste,
the heavenly assembly
qui rassemble sur la terre,
that gathers on earth.
Et c'est pourquoi,
and that is why
les bergers ont été rassemblés immédiatement,
the shepherds were gathered immediately without any delay.
À Jérusalem, lors de la
in Jerusalem, when there was the triumphant entry of Jesus, they sang Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed be is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. They were gathered because Jesus was clothed with the power from on high. They sang and they sang and sang.
Cette armée qui rassemble plus,
that army that gathers,
forte que la
is stronger
Niagara en Amérique,
than the Niagara water force
en Afrique,
in the US.
Victoria,
it is stronger than the Victoria force in Zimbabwe.
S'emporte tous et son passage.
It is a waterfall that takes everything on its way. In Revelation 19,
it
says, and I heard a multitude of heaven that said, power, salvation be to our God. This crowd was brazen. The Bible says they were like the voice of mighty waters. You are going to receive this today. I remember, it's been many years now, more than 40 years ago, when I began public evangelism. And I began with a choir that was called the Instruments of God. And when we sang, people were running to listen to us. And you, the choir and worshippers of churches, what are you doing with this grace in which you have been enrolled by grace? Sometimes people spend their time to do shows, and yet the multitude, they were singing. And we see that in Revelation 19 is the same as in Bethlehem when Jesus was born.
Oh hallelujah!
Oh hallelujah!
Jésus était parti dans le ciel.
Jesus went into heaven, but he left this power of gathering on earth. And that is why when we go from city to city, we gather people to hear the word of God through us. And when we go for other conquest, we leave. Armies of gathering, public and indoor.
Oh hallelujah!
Oh hallelujah! And today I read with you a number of scriptures. The first scripture, the Bible speaks.
They
said, "I saw the bodies of heaven were shaken, and the stars fell to the ground. Then appeared the sign of the Son of Man, who was coming on the clouds of heaven." I would love to help the church by preaching and teaching too. I evangelize and I also prophesy. Sometimes people are not aware that there are certain words I give that are prophecies.
Ce que j'appelle ici,
what I call here,
l'assemblée céleste,
the heavenly assembly,
la voyons avec Jésus,
we see it with Jesus
sous la forme de nuée,
in the form of a cloud.
Il vient avec les...
He will come hallelujah upon the cloud. Hallelujah and hallelujah.
Et on verra.
Says we will see him. We will see coming on the clouds of heaven. Hallelujah and hallelujah. The Son of Man coming with great power and glory. And those clouds are going to take their real form, which is the heavenly beings, angels, that God will send to the four corners of the earth to gather the elect. I am going to baptize you today in the cloud of the Son of Man. Oh, hallelujah. If you were baptized in water, today I would love that you should be baptized in the cloud. As the Bible says, they were baptized in Moses in the cloud and in the sea. But for me, I want you to be baptized in the cloud of gathering.
Oh, hallelujah!
Oh, hallelujah and hallelujah. God is good. The times are coming when we are going to all be gathered before Him, coming from all the four corners of the earth. He was coming upon the clouds. That is why it is written in Revelation chapter 1 verse 7. It says, behold, He comes upon the clouds. Every eye will see Him. Oh, hallelujah. What I'm speaking to you, Pastor, if you were not visible, you are going to become visible. Oh, yes. The cloud will make you to be visible. It is going to make you to be visible in your city, in your nation, in your continent, and in the world. You are going to be visible. And the Bible says, all eyes will see, you will be seen. The Son of Man is visible. People are looking for the visibility of their ministry and their calling in ways of pride, in low ways, in dirty ways. Today I am proposing to you a holy way for your visibility.
It
says we'll see Him coming on the clouds. You are going to be seen, dear pastor, dear evangelist. You will be seen. You will be seen. You will no longer be in the cave. You are going to be on the roof of the world. And today I'm proposing to you this roof. Gathering by the heavenly assembly, that is the cloud. And in Revelations chapter 1 verse 7 to 8, again they say, behold, He comes. Every eye will see Him. He comes upon the cloud. Every eye will see Him. Even those who pierced Him. That is why I am not afraid of people who insult me, who pierce me, and who hurt me. Let them. They will see you. They will see you with the clouds. Even those who pierced Him, they will see Him. They are going to regret to have pierced Him. I believed the Samaritan woman, the man who had made this woman to suffer, who had pierced the heart of this woman. I believe these men saw her on the clouds of the Son of Man. Behold, He comes upon the clouds. Every eye will see Him, even those who pierced Him. And He comes upon the clouds. Says, I am the Lord God Almighty, who was, who is, and who is to come. Oh, hallelujah. What a stage for gathering and of visibility that I am proposing to you, giving to you. Believe me, you are going to emerge. No one is going to drown your ministry. No one is going to drown your personality. You are going to emerge. Every eye will see Him as the Lord God Almighty, who was, who is to come, the universal ruler. As I am the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. And I've spoken that this power that we call the heavenly assembly, it is also called the clouds of heaven. Jesus was brought to land on the earth by the clouds of heaven. In the same way, he was taken back to heaven in the clouds. Oh, hallelujah. He says, "You Galilean men, why are you standing there staring at Jesus Christ? This same Jesus who has been taken up from you will come back in the same manner." And that is why we read it in Matthew 25. "When the Son of Man will come in the glory of his Father." Oh, hallelujah. I'd love to say to you, dear brothers, you need to have fathers who are in glory, not in shame. If your father is in the glory, you too will be in the glory. Your glory will come, because the Son of Man will come in the glory of his Father with all his angels. Here they are no longer called clouds, they are being called angels. We see them again in Matthew 24. It says he will send his angels with a trumpet call. It is not clouds, it is angels. Receive the angels of great gathering. It says all the nations will be gathered before him. I don't know how to explain these things to you today. I feel my soul filled with the glory of God, the glory of the glory, the glory of the glory. And that is why I am saying hallelujah to the Son of Man. He comes in the glory of his Father. And that is why I'm speaking to you about the heavenly assembly. It says all the nations will be gathered. And this is what I wanted to share with you today. It is gathering by the heavenly assembly. I will end by saying to you, Jesus said, "Wait in Jerusalem until you are clothed with the power from above. Wait in the city." You need to wait for this heavenly assembly by the true and authorized way that is eternal. They waited in a good manner. If the church does not begin to pray, the heavenly assembly is not going to land in order to gather. In the upper room, they began to pray. As they were praying, there was a landing of the heavenly assembly. And the Bible says, the city of Jerusalem ran towards their gathering. If you wait for this gathering by true faith, that is the way of prayer, the heavenly assembly will land. As it landed in the upper room, let me tell you something. That this assembly that landed in the upper room, it was an assembly. There are people who have assemblies that are not mobile. There are people who have got fixed or static assemblies, which are churches. But the assembly that landed in the upper room was an assembly on the move. It says, "Wait in Jerusalem until you are clothed from the power from above, and you are going to be my witnesses." You are going to gather in Jerusalem, in Judea. You are going to gather and gather and gather until the ends of the earth. Receive, dear evangelist, the mobile assembly. says, wait. We wait in prayer. Says the shepherds were without knowledge, and their sheep were scattered because they did not seek for the Lord. Many people are seeking for many and many things. Today I want you to seek the heavenly assembly through prayer. May God bless you, and that in your assemblies you should know that there is an assembly in the assembly. Oh, hallelujah. There is the assembly in the assembly. That is why you need to be serious. There are people who are not serious with the assemblies of God. There is the heavenly assembly in the earthly assembly. May God bless you until next time. And I pray that you may live in this glory, the power from above, the cloud, by a life of prayer in order to gather. Or else, time is short. I would have spoken to you about dethroning those who control great gathering. Says the power from above shook the heavenly bodies, the stars fell down, then appeared this heavenly assembly. Those who don't want the gathering, shake them by prayer, these spirits in high places, like Paul and Silas. They prayed and the prison was shaken. May God bless you until next time, and I say amen. Hallelujah. Thank you for following. Let us spread faith all around the world through this teaching.